our studies. We miss work, we ignore our household chores just to catch a glimpse of the action. We have even elected a former cricketer as Prime Minister, although some would call him selected Prime Minister. But have you ever thought of the consequences of this cricket craze? Have you ever thought about the thousands of fights that happen over the TV remote control when a cricket match is going on? Have you thought about the thousands of delicious meals that have been left to burn on the stove because a thrilling cricket match was going on? And on a more serious note, have you thought about the thousands of youngsters who have dropped out of school, out of college, out of university to pursue their dream of wearing a green shirt? The vast majority of these club and street cricketers can now be found struggling to make ends meet. Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and our distinguished guests, we need to put an end to this madness. We need to protect our future generation from this addiction. We need to ban cricket in Pakistan. Now I can spot a few cricket fans in the room getting a little agitated, but bear with me, fellows, because I have only just begun. You see, cricket is a very strange old game. It has three different formats, each with its own kit and some very complicated rules. Try explaining the L1P2b rule to a fifth grader and you'll understand exactly what I mean. And let's not even talk about the Duckworth-Lewis method. It's perhaps the only instance in world sport where a mathematical calculation is used to derive a result of a contest. But just because a sport is complicated does not mean we should ban it. And I wholeheartedly agree. The primary reason why we should ban cricket, however, is because it's a massive waste of time. The most popular format of cricket, the one-day international, lasts up to 8 hours and takes up the entire workday. But the best, the purest form of cricket, the test match, can last up to 5 days. But you know what the worst part is? The worst part is that one-third of all test matches end in a draw without any result. Even the most passionate cricket fan, even the most crazy cricket fan, can find a better way to spend 5 days than watching a boring, drawn test match. It is therefore not surprising, really, that the International Cricket Council was forced to introduce a much shorter version of the game, the T20 format, to curtail the dwindling popularity of the sport. But make no mistake, cricket is a dinosaur. This lazy sport has no place in the 21st century, and there is ample data to prove this assertion. The International Cricket Council, after over 100 years of international cricket, has just 10 full members. Just 10 test playing nations are allowed to play test cricket at a competitive level. Compare that to Football FIFA Federation, which has over 200 members. Compare that to International Tennis Federation that has over 210 members. Does it make any sense participating in promoting a sport that has such a bleak future? A sport that revolves around the whims and wishes of the so-called big three nations, Australia, England, and India. And that reminds me of a very important point. If you notice, all these 10 test-playing nations are basically former colonies of the British Empire. Cricket was brought to the subcontinent during the British Raj, a time when our forefathers, when our great-grandparents were treated as third-class citizens in their own land. Cricket is therefore a reminder of the subjugation and humiliation that our forefathers faced hands of their British masters. Should we promote a sport that makes a mockery of the sacrifices of our great-grandparents? Personally, I find it deeply disturbing that whenever an international cricket tournament is going on, millions of Pakistanis are glued to their TV sets, forgetting all their responsibility, forgetting all their problems. Even though the last time we won the World Cup was back in 1992, many of you, I believe, were not even born back then. Compare that to other sports, forgotten sports like hockey, like squash that have brought even more glory, even more trophies, even more recognition internationally. Those sports have not been given the same attention as cricket. So maybe it's finally time to bury this relic of our colonial powers. Maybe it's time to adopt another sport that is not tainted by controversies and allegations of match fixing, spot fixing, ball tampering. Surely it's time to ban cricket in Pakistan. Over to the Toastmaster team.